And for the last topic in this module, I wanted to talk about side channel attacks. And I have to say this past the basics of this, it even makes my mind shudder. I refer to this as the true Sherlock Holmes of attacks. And really what this is a physical attack on a cryptographic device. And here's what I mean as a physical attack. This is a piece of hardware that we're attacking that's doing the cryptography. And we want to find a way to be able to attack this device to figure out what information is being sent. But here's what's unique about it. And this sounds kind of strange. The attack is based on how the algorithms are implemented, not on the algorithm itself. So instead of attacking the math, attacking the algorithm and trying to figure it out, what we're actually trying to do is, well, listen to the device and see if there's a non-direct way to understand what's going on. Now, I have an example here in a second, but there's a few ways to do this. Power consumption, and we can do what's called a simple or differential power analysis, where we can determine, generating through these algorithms chews up more power. So maybe there's a power consumption method that when it's working through the algorithm, we could start to detect what changes are there. You see what I mean? This gets really intense. We can measure variations of the electromagnetic field on a chip as it's doing the calculations, and from that glean some additional hope. There's even ways by light. There are people that can, by a monitor, broadcasting itself against a wall, they can see the shifting in light against the wall to see what's actually written on the monitor. This is how this kind of works. We're attacking not the algorithm, but we're attacking the device, and finding weaknesses of the device is really the goal. Acoustic attacks, and this is one of the best examples I can give because I think this really kind of comes in. Do you remember the old rotary phones? Probably not. But here's a very simple one, because I actually did this as just as a study long time ago. You could tell by the clicks when somebody was using a rotary phone. You could tell by the clicks when it was snapping back what number they had dialed. So if you just listen to somebody as they're dialing a number, you can write down what the telephone number is. See, that's a side channel attack. There's other things. The particular click and clacking of a keyboard. Anything that emits sounds. You may have seen, was it War Games, where he was using a coin or a bottle top or something to try to connect a phone. Well, it used to be in the old days, you could whistle into a phone just like a modem does. And you could make connections to systems this way by whistling through it. There was also a way to even open up the phone and allow it to dial long distance without recording it. Now, these methods don't work anymore. These are the old phone phreaking things that used to be able to be done. But there's ways to exploit it through sound and all that kind of stuff. So side channel attacks, the moral of the story is we're attacking the device, not really the algorithm. And so you can imagine the science involved in this and trying to figure out a way to detect how to crack what's going on by one of these methods. And it's definitely very interesting. This is something that you might actually get really interested into and do more studies on, kind of like what I got interested in it and did the whole rotary phone thing. Although we don't you don't hear people dialing on phones anymore with everybody's cell phone, but there's a lot of ways that you can dive further into side channel attacks.